Welcome to this video. Are you interested in why your vehicle diagnosis displays U146D64? How is the error code interpreted by the vehicle? What does U146D64 mean, or how to correct this fault? Today we will find answers to these questions together. Let's do this. First, let's look at the history of diagnostic fault code composition according to the OBD2 protocol, which is unified for all automakers since 2000. We divide the electric system of automobile into the four basic units: powertrain, body, chassis, network. This distribution is defined in the first character code. If the second character is expressed as zero, it is a standardized error. In the case of numbers 1, 2, 3, it is a more prestigious expression of the car-specific error. The third character specifies a subset of errors. The distribution shown is valid only for the standardized DTC code. Only the last two characters define the specific fault of the group. The add-on to the error code serves to specify the status in more detail. For example, a short to the ground. Let's not forget that such a division is valid only if the other character code is expressed by the number zero. Our website airbagreset.sk produces useful videos for you. You do not have to go through the OBD2 protocol anymore to know how to troubleshoot any car breakdown. You will find all the diagnostic codes that can be diagnosed in a Jeep vehicles, also many other useful things. The following demonstration will help you look into the world of software for car control units. You unbelievably can move the video a bit further. The error code is split into two bytes consisting of 16 bits. One bit is the basic unit that each computer works with. The bit has two logical states: 0, low level, 1, high level. By combining the first two bits, the basic character of the error code is expressed. The next two bits again determine the second character. The last bit styles of the first byte define the third character of the code. The second byte is composed of a combination of 8 bits. The first 4 bits determine the fourth character of the code, and the combination of the last 4 bits defines the fifth character. A single byte conceals 256 possible combinations. We now know in what way the diagnostic tool translates the received information into a more comprehensible format. The number itself does not make sense to us if we cannot assign information about it to what it actually expresses. So, what does the diagnostic trouble code U146D64 interpret specifically for Jeep car manufacturers? The basic definition is evap leak detection pump control circuit low. And now this is a short description of this DTC code. Engine started, battery voltage must be at least 115 V, all electrical components must be off, parking brake must be engaged to keep daytime driving lights off, automatic transmission selector must be in park, the exhaust system must be properly sealed between the catalytic converter and the cylinder head, coolant temperature must be at least 80 degrees Celsius and oxygen sensor heaters for oxygen sensors before the catalytic converter must be functioning properly and the ground between the engine and the chassis must be well connected. The DME detected voltage irregularity in the leak detection pump control circuit. This diagnostic error occurs most often in these cases: evap LDP power supply circuit is open, evap LDP solenoid valve is damaged or it has failed, evap LDP canister has a leak or a poor seal, evap canister system has an improper seal, evaporative emission, evap canister purge regulator valve 1 has failed, leak detection pump LDP is faulty, aftermarket evap parts that do not conform to specifications, evap component seals leaking, i.e., leaks in the purge valve, fuel tank pressure sensor, canister vent solenoid, fuel vapor control valve tube assembly or fuel vapor vent valve signal plausibility failure. This subtype is used for failures where the control module detects a single input parameter for plausibility. The Airbag Reset website aims to provide information in 52 languages. Thank you for your attention and stay tuned for the next video.